There's never been a better time to have SiriusXM. With over 140 channels in your vehicle, your all-access trial includes more than ever before to enjoy online, on your phone, or at home. Create your own ad-free personalized stations powered by Pandora. Hear ad-free extra channels and enjoy favorite shows with SiriusXM Video on Demand. What you love is on now.
So if you're a dealer and you're tuning into our Powersports sessions, then I'm going to guess that you're pretty curious about maybe getting into it. And if you are, then arguably there isn't a brand that's been doing it longer and deeper than the one that we're going to be talking to today. And that is, of course, Rockford Fosgate. We're blessed enough to have the return of Mr. Eric Russelll, their product specialist. They'll be joining us, talk about a couple key items, especially a focus on a brand new release that just came out this week, if you've been paying attention. This is CMA Connected, presented by SiriusXM. Rockford Fosgate Power Sports Audio starts now. What's going on, everybody, and thanks for tuning in to another CMA Connected presented by SiriusXM. I'm your host, Ben Wu. Power Sports Audio, where did this category come from? Boom, came out of nowhere, but there are those that had the foresight to know that this was something that was growing underground on a grassroots level, and now it's pretty much reached epic proportions. Many different platforms, so many enthusiasts gather at events every weekend, and if you're not in this, providing this type of product and service to your customers, or maybe you don't even know these customers exist, we're going to talk about that today. So before we get this session underway, we're going to get our Canadian distributor, Rockford Fosgate, onto the screen. With me, of course, it's Stephen Colombe, who's the product specialist for Automobility.
Hey, Ben.
What's going on, Steve? It's a fun one today.
It is, yes. Another flagship brand of ours that's, you know, we're going to expand a bit more on exciting new products that just came out. So expanding again to a new generation of kits, to purpose-built kits, you know.
Purpose-built is obviously the theme that we know and we love from Rockford Fosgate. But, you know, how do they keep coming up with these things? Like, at first, when they first came up with the, with these application-specific kits, wow, that's a mouthful. A lot of people are like, wow, is there really market enough to kind of create all this engineering, all this research into building a kit just for one platform, one vehicle? I guess they saw something that nobody else did, because now it's like that's the deal and they're kind of leading the way in it.
Yeah, that new kit is now on Gen 2, so it's the second generation of kits, which we're going to talk about very soon. The other ones are all on Generation 3, so, you know, it's been years already. So the market has been growing expansionally in the last years in that category. So,
you know, you guys sell, you know, Rockford brand to obviously Marine. We covered that a couple days ago. Of course, we got motorcycle coming up, which is obviously a huge category, but power sports got to be one. I don't even know which one's bigger. They all seem to be that big when it comes to Rockford. Why don't we get our product specialist on with us today? We're going to have a really nice conversation. We'll talk about some new product, and hopefully we can squeeze in for some insight as to what advice we can get dealers to take advantage of all these great products from Rockford. So without further ado, let's invite Mr. Eric Russelll, who's the product specialist, joining us today from Rockford Fosgate in Arizona.
Hey, Ben. It's always great to be with you.
Good to have you again, Mr. Russelll. You know, it takes somebody who's been there long enough, and when I say long enough, it's 3 decades, to join us to be really, you know, I love it because I can ask you literally everything from what was, you know, the wallpaper in whatever room in that office 10 years ago to this whole story about power sports. So thank you for joining us.
I appreciate that very much, Ben. It's always been a pleasure to work here, and I'd love to talk to you about new products that we've got coming out today.
Well, we're definitely going to dive into the new product for sure. But I want to take 1 second and set the mood. I'm going to let you talk about it, obviously. But we have a video that we're going to play to show these people visually what this new product's all about, the touchy, the feely, all that good stuff. Let's roll the tape and see what Rockford has been up to.
We'll be right back.
there you have it, the recent generation of the Ranger platform from Polaris, and Rockford coming up. What did you say, Steve? This is their second generation kit? Did correct. I get that
yeah.
right?
Yeah, for that platform, yes, it is.
Before I literally give you the mic and let you tell us all about this new kit, I want to take a second here to recognize something that I think Rockford marketing really got nailed on the head. We've seen great videos from Rockford. Actually, we're going to see another one later on in this episode. But, you know, the typical Razor, get dirty, mud, kind of motorsport kind of feel. Did you notice that this one wasn't quite about that? This was about friends getting together, campfire, you know what I'm saying, getting away for the weekend kind of deal. And we're going to talk about that because I feel, and you mentioned it on live earlier this week, Eric, you need to understand your customer. Right. And there are different types of customers that have kind of come up now within the power sports segment. Would you agree with that statement, Eric?
Absolutely. Yeah. So we're going to talk about looking at your market and how to get the right product mix in your store to help make that customer connection really, really awesome.
That's it. All right. We'll circle back with that. I'm going to let you go. Eric, tell us all about this new release for the Ranger.
Okay. All right. So thanks, Ben. As you just saw in the video, Rockford Fosgate released new performance audio kits for Polaris Ranger. Now, this is for the 2018 and newer XP1000. If you have been paying attention to us, you notice that we launched in a stage one kit that was released in the end of last year, 2021. And it's a self-contained unit that literally takes 5 minutes to install. You pull it out of the box, you pop off the dash panel, put it on, and plug in the power, and you're ready to go. So we're super happy to be able to expand on that and announce 7 new kits in addition to that lineup. So now we go from stage 1 to 5, and then we have a stage 1 through 6, and stage 5 and 6 for Ride Command as well.
You know, a question that we get often is, you know, why are there so many stages? Why don't you just make 1 or 2 kits? What is the theory behind that?
That's a great question. So it kind of offers a good, better, best option. So as you can see, the speakers behind me, the base layer is our M0. Those are non-illuminated, but still element ready. So that way you get all the DNA of Rockford Fosgate in your performance audio kit. And then we step up to an M1 series, which has the color optics RGB illumination. And then we step up to the M2 series, which allows for interchangeable grills. You have a stainless or a sport grill. So it allows you to customize the aesthetics to the interior of the vehicle. So that's kind of our good, better, best stage. And then in Ranger, this is a completely new way that we're doing the kits. You're gonna see kits that show front and rear options. So typically we just do one option, and this allows for a customer to choose the right path, and it allows them for upgradability at a later point.
All right, very interesting. So right out of the gate, you're offering customers a good, better, best scenario as far as trim, right? We'll call that the trim. But how many pieces are we talking? Break down this whole kit for us, would you?
So starting off with the stage 2, it is a front and rear component system, and it's basically powered off the deck unit. So you have a PMX1 source unit, 2 M0 6.5-inch in the front, and then 2 6.5-inch speakers in the rear. And then when we jump up to stage 3, we're going to add a subwoofer under the passenger seat, and we're going to change it from a PMX1 to a PMX2. So you have a little bit more flexibility, Pandora radio, and it's also upgrading you to the M1 speakers, so you have color optics. And then we're going to jump up to stage 4, which is adding rear speaker pods to that same kit. And then stage 5 is a completely upgrade from there. So we're going to change the radio from a PMX2 to a PMX3 that allows you to add Sirius XM radio and a backup camera. And we're changing the amplifier from an 800 watt up to a 1500 watt amplifier. And we're also upgrading the speakers. For the stage 5, it's front and sub in the M2 series, so you have the stainless steel grill option. And then you have a stage 6, which adds the rear speakers. And then we also have 5 and 6 available for Ride Command. So if you want to retain the Ride Command source unit, You can use that as the deck power for the audio system. So in a stage five, which is again the front and sub, you can use the ride command as your source unit. And then stage six allows for the rear pods as well. So we've got a complete lineup depending on what your budget is or your performance needs. We've got a kit for you.
Okay, lots of different questions for you here, Eric. So the first one I want to ask you is, when it comes to subwoofer, what size of subwoofer? Is there a housing, and does it just bolt right into a factory location?
Yeah, so it basically, in Ranger, you've got the passenger side that has a five-gallon bucket location that's embossed in the floorboard, and we're taking that spot. So it does fit in a factory location. There is no drilling required on any of the kits. It uses all factory mounting points. So that goes for the front speaker pods, the rear, and the subwoofer itself.
Okay. Now, as far as the head unit, when you said ride command, you're talking about integrating, getting the sound output from the original ride command head unit or source unit. How do we have to get external wire harnesses, adapters? How does that work?
We include a brand new ride command interface harness for you. So it is the only noise-free ride command interface option on the market as of now. It's basically, it eliminates a lot of the pulse width modulation noise that you'll get over the chassis. It's mainly we developed that for Razor when you have dynamic suspension. For Ranger, that's not quite such an issue, but we do include the adapter with the ride command kits for stages five and six.
Oh, so there's no wire, no soldering, nothing. It just click, 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 plug and play.
You got it.
All right, my other question, based on what you just told me there, is when it comes to the stage five and six, to now add the rear speaker pods. By pods, you do mean tower speakers. Is that the same type of tower speaker we see in Marine?
These are different. So we're they're not the same. Moto cans. We're actually, they are pods that bolt to the roof. So if you're looking at a kit that has rear pods, you definitely need to have the factory Polaris Ranger poly roof. And that already has embosses in it, so that way you can just mount that trim ring up into the poly roof and then mount the speakers to that. So they are basically just the speakers that you see right behind me. It's a normal 6.5 inch, and it's just a trim ring that mounts to that poly roof.
So Eric, you're talking about integrating into the ride command and being able to get the signal out for stage five and six. But does that come with the type of interface? Do I have to order that separate, or how does that work?
Yeah, it does. We supply a ride command interface that Rockford Fosgate designed and engineered right here in Tempe, Arizona. And it's really great for eliminating any sort of pulse width modulation electronic noise on the chassis. Now, that's really geared for the Polaris Razors that have dynamic suspension. Ranger, not so much of a big deal. But we do include that interface in the ride command kits for stage five and six.
Oh, so really, we're talking true plug and play.
Right out of the box.
All right. So we covered the different stages that are available. We covered the interface and actually three different source units, depending on what stage you go into. I can't help but notice that you have a piece behind you on the left. I'm wondering if you can go over and grab that and show that to us.
Yeah. So this is our dedication to the fit and finish. So this is a front speaker pod for the Ranger. And as you can see, the texture matches what you would normally see in the OEM panels. And of course, it's completely wired, so it is literally a plug-and-play system. There's a connection to the harness. And of course, these are all waterproof connections. So these are IPX6 rated. And just our commitment to, again, the purpose-built application of the product to make sure that it's seamless in the vehicle itself. So it's really hard sometimes to tell where the OEM panel ends and where the aftermarket begins.
So I noticed there's a nice little embossed logo for Rockford on the front. Do you mind if we take a look at the connection? Just want to see the quality of those connections. I don't want to skip by that. I noticed they're fully loomed as well on top of that. And I see the texture now. Yeah, absolutely. And those are all waterproof connections as well. They're kind of like Deutsche style.
Yeah, here's the Deutsche connector in here. So this will go for your color optic speaker.
Oh, yeah.
And it's got the rubber seal around the edge. So yeah, all the connections are waterproof. So if you do get water ingress into the system somehow, you're not going to have a problem with it shorting out on the speaker.
Steve, have you had the chance to play with any of these parts and get your hands on them and touch them? And like what's your feedback on these type of kits?
I did. And those kits are truly OE grade material, like Eric just mentioned, you know, the attention to detail is next level. So there's no concern on installing that and looking in as an aftermarket kit, if you want to call it like that. But that being said, every kit is well assembled. Everything is in the box. You don't have to look for anything. Like you asked earlier, it's plug and play, 100% plug and play. It's not a plug and play that needs some, you know, tweaks.
Yeah, because you know the term plug and play is kind of being like used and abused in our industry in the past. But I know when Rockford says that, well, I think Eric's about to prove a point here. What do you want to show us here, Eric?
Yeah, so here's the wiring harness for Ranger. It's pre-loomed, pre-terminated. So you've got your power connector. This is the subwoofer connector for the 5-channel amplifier. And then you've got more connections directly into the amplifier itself. And of course, Deutsch connectors. So this is all pre-loomed, pre-terminated, and it's the exact length. So you don't have to actually trim or cut anything. The harness, you literally pull it out and then just run it down. Depending on what vehicle it is, on Ranger, it's gonna go down the center channel, and you're ready to go.
Do you provide that type of detail in the instructions as well as to where to run the cables?
We do. In fact, I helped with the latest install videos that were just released Tuesday, and we go through everything that's in the kit and show you how to install it. Now, for people, dealers, installers that are new to the kit, they'll probably just have to get a quick overview on the video. Other than that, this is a really, really easy, and it was a fun kit to install in the Ranger.
Very, very cool. What level of difficulty would you put that on? 10? 10 being, or 10 being, you know, super difficult.
How's for Ranger, it was a lot of fun. I would say it was probably a 3 or 4 wrench.
Yeah, oh, that's it. Yeah. Okay. Very, very cool. What else do you want to show us today, Eric?
We've got our IPX6 amplifier. This is the M5 amplifier that is included in the kit. So this is the 800-watt amplifier that comes with the Stage 3. And then the larger 5-channel amplifier comes with Stage 4. And the things to note on this are the IPX6 waterproof cover. There is a seal on here to keep water from ingress into the controls itself or your game pots. And then on the ends, we have these molded connectors that are secured in with screws on both sides. And there's actually a splash guard on the top here. So if water does splash on, it'll roll off and not get into the connectors itself. And that's on both sides. So this allows you to extend that wiring out if you wanted to put it into a waterproof housing. It's the same connectors that we had on the TM series. So it's very similar if you use any of the TM400X4 amplifiers. This is a direct replacement for it. And we're using it on all the Ranger kits. The 800-watt, again, is on the Stage 3. And the 1500-watt 5-channel is on Stage 4, 5, and 6.
I want to take a second and talk about those amplifiers before you put that away, Eric, if you don't mind. These amplifiers, they didn't just come out. They did come out last year, I believe. But I want to comment on the design of these. So it's very important that we mention the thought process, Eric, of why the wires are the way they are. You know, if you took a marine amplifier, a lot of the marine amplifiers, even I believe Rockford's own, you know, the controls are on the bottom and all the plugs are on the bottom. But why is it different for this one? I know there's some design element here.
Well, these are super compact. So this is a Class 80 amplifier. So the topology allows us to get it in a smaller footprint. And the previous generation was fan cooled. So the heatsink has been changed slightly to eliminate the fans and keep a waterproof seal on both sides. And of course, on the top. With motorsport applications, you literally don't have to tune this. I normally build a tuning guide on how to set the switches and set the gain controls and everything on UTV systems. But with the new M5 amplifiers, it has a preset switch. It's already defaulted on, and you'll see this sticker. There's also a yellow piece of paper that comes in the box on the amplifier that says, wait, stop, do not do anything. This is already pre-tuned for your Ranger. So all you have to do is connect it and enjoy it.
That's awesome. Any feedback? I'd like to hear, Steve, because you have had these amplifiers in the lineup for a couple of months at least. Now the dealers have had it. I'd like to hear what any feedback that you have about these.
Well, the feature that Eric just described, which is the amplifiers being pre-tuned, makes it even, you know, next level plug and play. So you don't even have to bother trying to adjust and fine tune. you can do it if you want, you know, if the customer has some specific needs. But again, it's a plug and play kit. So the power of these amps, again, we talked about them on the last episode, but the dynamic power on them brings the speakers even more to life with those, you know, the new M5 generation. So
it's too bad that on a lot of these Powersport applications, you hide the amplifiers, because I got to say, that one is a really good looking one. You know what I mean? I'd show it off if I could, because it's not always available space to do.
Well, we do have some dealers that do also install them in cars because they look so good, you know, so.
Mm-hmm. Makes sense. They do look good. I'm not going to lie. All right, Eric. Thanks for van whiting that for so long. Sorry about that. just What else do we got going on?
Well, we just want to talk about the purpose-built applications that we manufacture and integrate into the product. So all of our engineering research and development happen right here in Tempe, Arizona. Of course, we are in a very sunny environment. We have a lot of UV rays here in Arizona. So it's super easy for us to put it in a test vehicle and torture test it for several months. And we really understand how to make the product better. Like Steve mentioned in the opening, we're in multiple generations of our UTV kits. Generation 3 for the Can-Am and the Polaris Razor. And we're on Gen 2 for the Ranger. So it's our commitment again to further improve the product, get the better features out there that dealers are asking for. And it really does come back down to a lot of that dealer feedback is what pushes us and drives us to make the next generation better than before.
So stage 2 on Ranger, but stage 3 on Polaris, Razor and whatnot. Can you walk us through a couple of things that stand out that you've seen now that you've been doing this for so long, that really popped out as things that had to change or be improved upon? Like, what have you learned throughout all these stages?
Well, you know, everybody can build an RGB speaker, but we designed it so that it's purpose-built. So the Centrex is molded into the actual product itself. So if you, by chance, scratch the plastic, it's not going to start degrading and peeling from there. So you're going to be protected from any sort of UV rays. And of course, all these speakers, the M0, M1, and M2, are IPX rated. So any sort of water spray, any sort of dirt, dust, mud. We just came back from Mud Nationals down south, and it was amazing the amount of mud that gets caked on a UTV. And it's really easy. You just take the hose and rinse it off, and you're good to go for the next event.
Very, very cool. Let's talk about culture for a second. Unless there's another product you wanted to jump into real quick, or was there another product you wanted to get to? Yeah.
I mean, we have for Polaris Razor and Can-Am X3. So Can-Am, we have 6 stages. Again, it's a very, very similar step up. So we go from M0 on stage 1 and 2. Stage 3 and 4, we jump up to the M1 series. And then we jump up again for stages 5 and 6 to the M2 series. Now, what's super cool on the Polaris Razor and Can-Am kits is stage 6, we're replacing the normal motorsport cans with full marine wig tower horns. So we've got something if you want it loud, stage 5, but if you want to go ultimately loud.
I'm going to stop you for a second. I need to understand something. You are the driver. If you're going to put these marine grade cans behind you, what would you say, Steve? You're like, what, 2 feet, 3 feet, maximum 4 feet from your ear to the surface of that can behind you, roughly?
Pretty much. Like, if you're tall, a tall dude like me, yes, you're even closer.
But that's ridiculous. Like, have you ever, nobody's ever listened to these things. If you're standing 3 to 4 feet in front of these type of speakers, they're going to blow your face off. But you're telling me, Eric, that this is what these guys want.
Yeah, so we see a lot of guys when they're going out camping in the forest or out in the desert, they love to actually turn them because you can swivel the speakers, point them backward, and then you can just park it next to the campfire and you can enjoy music no matter what you're doing, cornhole, just roasting some marshmallows, whatever. So it's great entertainment. But yes, it is loud. I thought that when we came out with the Stage 5, I'm like, who is going to buy this because it is so freaking loud. And then we came out with the Stage 6 And I, when it's in the studio, I can't listen to it. It's too loud. So it's purposely built for the outdoors. When you are in an open air environment, you notice that they do sound different than any other sports product, because we frequency response tailor the product so that it sounds better. You don't have a windshield per se on most UTVs where you're reflecting sound waves off of glass and door panels and leather and stuff like that. In a UTV, you pretty much just have door panels. Now in a Ranger, you may have like a North Star that has glass, which is very, very cool, by the way. But you are allowed to, you know, change the EQ on the PMX source unit to adapt to that. But as far as the speakers and the whole setup, it's tuned for an outdoor environment.
Yep. Ben. Listen, I'm not here to judge. I'm just saying that is crazy. Like
the real, the real answer to that question is why not? Well, that's a real quick.
Fair enough. Fair. I'll give
go
you
big or go home.
Yeah, go big or go home. And that is absolutely huge. All right. Back to you, Eric.
All right. So, yeah, we want to talk about if you're a dealer new into this market, you know, look at what your friends are riding around in. So if you're a car audio shop new into motorsports and you want to get into the business, take a look at what is available in your area. You might find in your Canadian territories more utility. Now, out here in Arizona and in California, we see a lot more performance enhanced UTVs. You're going to see a lot of Turbo S's, a lot of Can-Am X3s, you know, built for speed. But when you're out camping and enjoying the nature and outdoors, we do see a lot of utilities. And actually, where I grew up in Gilbert, Arizona, we have a lot of farms. So I had farmland all the way around my house. And I see a lot of Polaris Rangers out there doing work. Some generals, so that way you can kind of take it off a little bit off-road. But I see a lot of Rangers. So basically, take a look at your market and see what is being purchased, what consumers are actually driving out there. And then that way you can intelligently stock the right product in your store.
I'm going to comment on that for sure. I did some time, you know, the sportsman shows are kind of happening right now. I'm actually off to one this weekend. And I talked to a couple of dealers, and by far, what you just said, nailed it. That performance motorsport market is here, but definitely nowhere as prominent or as popular as the dual utility market. That Ranger Polaris is one of the number one sellers in that category. So having this new kit come at this time, I think it could be a big home run for our Canadian dealers, Steve. I'd like to hear what you have to say.
Yeah, Eric just nailed it, meaning that when guys build performance UTVs, they won't necessarily add all the audio and the extra weight, right? So it's more, it is more of a, you know, on the more utility vehicles that you may add or, you know, increase the audio system. And so, yeah, totally.
Absolutely. Good timing on that Ranger, thing. Now, I wanted to kind of segue this conversation. Let's put this, if you don't mind, let's get us back into full screen here for a second so we can all see each other. The dealer, okay, as we get further down this conversation, and especially, and I'm referring, Steve, especially in Canada, okay, the dealer needs to start recognizing these opportunities to expand their business. You know, the car audio obviously is at the source of 90% of the dealers that are still around today that are doing really well. But now you've got the marine, you've got the bike, you've got now power sports. Step one, if you already have a customer, you've done their pickup, right? You've set them up with punches and all this great Rockford gear. Do they have a tow on the back of that truck? Because if they do, guess what? There's probably a toy behind it that they would probably, and I'm no expert, but probably appreciate that if you offered them this type of stuff, maybe they don't even know about it. Eric, I'd like to hear, and I know this is maybe 10 years ago where you are, but where we are, we're starting to get into it. And Steve knows what I mean. We're always a little bit behind to get to go. Once we get there, trust me, we're going to go deep, but we got to get there first.
Yeah, you know, Rockford Fosgate is no stranger to the comments from our consumers. You know, oh, you were all car audio and now you're just worried about motorcycles. Actually, no. It's that the owners of our previous car audio equipment are now older. You know, I'm 50 years old. I've got kids and, you know, I you know, want to do other things with my family outside of just driving in the car. So it's a matter of growing with that segment. And a lot of those customers now have boats, RVs, UTVs, something to enjoy with their family, but just other things, other toys other than their automobile.
Steve, well, I'd like to hear what you have to say about, I'm not trying to put us down that we're so far behind and that we're cavemen, but you know, I think you understand what I'm trying to say.
Well, yes, there's always the trends that happens in the US, always a bit delayed up here. It has been like that for a long time, you know, even for in other parts of the automotive industry, even for performance parts and everything else. But there's also the four seasons up here. I mean, Arizona has one season and it's UTV seasons and sand dunes, right? So so that's also another factor that when, you know, the opportunity is there with your customers, it's time to, when the summer gets here and the spring gets here, it's that time to try to focus on, you know, on those type of products, because we have a short amount of time and everyone gets excited. Now it's getting warmer, snow's melting around us. So it's that time to get into the...
As far as the Rockford lineup of the Powersport kits, Eric, what would you recommend as for a shop to invest into a demo vehicle? The whole thing? Sell the dream? Or is it more important to have, you know, just a couple key pieces of that people can kind of experience it in their showrooms?
Well, typically top down in sales, right? So you always show them the best offering that they have, that is available. And it allows you to sell the customer depending on what their budget needs are or their performance needs. So you can show them the stage six, but if he's just interested, he or she is interested in just the front speakers and a subwoofer, you can go down in kit. It's hard for them to visualize going up, but it's easier to go down. So I would say, you know, it's best to typically start off with a stage five or a six in your demo UTV, and then it's easy to go down in stage from there.
Yeah, absolutely. And probably I'm going to guess there's literature or information on the Rockford side that kind of breaks down all these kits that you could walk your customer through saying, listen, this is the whole, you know, the whole picture, but we can start you here and get you there, right? In these steps.
Absolutely. So I actually do the website for Rockford Fosgate. So Tuesday we did release everything for Polaris Ranger, and you just go to the motorsports page, click on that, and then you'll go to the Polaris kits, or you can do a vehicle year, make, model lookup, and then that way we'll give you the right kit for your particular UTV.
So we covered the new Polaris kit. We know already that there's amplifiers, different source units, the coaxial full range speakers. You have the small cans, and now some, for some reason, some people like these big marine cans in the back as well. That's great. Did we miss anything as far as categories?
For UTV, I mean, that's pretty much the core of it. The core is Can-Am X3 Polaris Razor, and Ranger obviously is a great utility vehicle. We get a lot of requests for it. You know, we do expand also into motorcycle audio, which is where a lot of these products are used as well. We do have other speakers that are specifically for motorcycle use, being a power sports type of product, but you can use these speakers in an RV, in a boat. So it does allow you to, you know, give you the same options as far as upgradability. You know, you've got a good, better, best scenario, M0, M1, M2, and that allows you to, you know, sell that customer the right product for their needs.
Well, very good. I always save this question for the end. Where are we looking like for inventory, fellas? Because obviously the season is upon us. Steven?
We're looking good. We have most of these kits in stock right now. We started loading them in last month. So, and the new kits that are that were released a couple of days ago also are on order. So right now, so they're about to, we're expecting them in the following 7 to 10 days to land Montreal. And yeah.
What's the number one kit sold so far, Steve?
Oh boy. Also so good. It's kind of hard to pinpoint. I'd say surprisingly, the stage five and six are selling very good because I think a lot of people want to go all out. We do have sold, a lot of those stage one kits also for the Rangers, because they're such a nice all-in-one piece, the latest ones. So And I have to add as well that, you know, the Gen 3 kits, Rockford did their homework and came up with the stage, also up to stage 6. But what they did is they listened to the, I guess, to the all the comments of everyone, and they really mapped down the exact parts that needed to be into each kit, meaning the stage 1 and 2 are the M0. Stage 3 and 4 with the M1s and upgrading the radio as well. And stage 5, 6 are the big boys. So,
yeah, so it's not just about volume. It's also about sound quality. It's about features like lighting. And it's also about features in that source unit as well. Because as you climb the source unit models, you unlock more and more features. So it's not just a one-dimension kind of upgrade. It's right across the board. Are you upgrading as you go up in the stages?
Yeah.
Very, very cool.
And if I could add one thing, you know, for the installers, we really thought about them this time. And I want to take a special note that the packaging that the kits come in, before you would just get a regular consumer package and it would be in a giant box. Now the Ranger kits are very specific. It's like a refrigerator. You cut the top off or the bottom off, you pull off the cardboard, and you have layers. And it's just the parts that you need for the Ranger installation. You don't get extra RCAs, you don't get high level input, stuff like that. You get the specific harness for the Ranger, you get the specific amplifier for the Ranger. And as you install the system, you'll just take the next layer off, install it, and then you should have no parts left over.
Wait, I just understood what you were just saying halfway through. Are you saying the box physically, as you unwrap it, it gives you step by step is what you need to do next?
Yep, so we cover that in our installation videos. It's just like a refrigerator. You'll cut at the bottom.
Yeah, okay. Now I understand what you're saying.
It folds down, and you're like, okay, layer one, let's go install it.
Okay, so don't do like what I normally do and just chuck everything on the garage floor and try to figure it out is what you're saying.
Well, sometimes it's like Christmas, right? Because you get a new kit.
Yeah, yeah. And usually the good stuff's on the bottom, right? Yeah. Eric, listen, great conversation. Congratulations on the new launch of that new Ranger kit. I can only expect, I mean, are there any more launches this year?
I can't officially say, but if you know Rockford, we are always innovating and always looking for the next best thing. So I'll keep that open to you.
Stay tuned.
Wink, wink.
Wink, wink. Well, so I hope we can get you back here when that announcement happens. Thank you so much for taking the time to walk us through this and to have this dialogue that I think is really important information for dealers to know.
My pleasure.
Take care, Eric. So, Steve, check another great kit to add to the box, the catalog for your dealers, for sure. Deep catalog when it comes to UTV. I mean, if you're going to get into, you know, this category, it's a hard argument that if you're not selling the Rockford kits, I mean, you're missing out on a couple key clutch items. Would you agree?
Correct. Again, like Eric mentioned in the last minutes, it is so... They have evolved so much within those three generations, and they really listen to the feedback from everyone, the dealers, the users, and they're really pinpointing every little detail as you saw, even for the newer kids that are coming out. So,
it's like they think of everything.
Yeah, no, it's
even the layering of the box. Man, that's next level.
That's plug and play.
Yeah.
A la deux.
Yeah. 2.0 plug and play.
2.0.
And the inventory looks good. So, guys, if you're interested in Rockford Fosgate, obviously call this guy, well, his team. I don't know if you'll be lucky enough to get him himself, but he has reps, right? Automobility, exclusive Canadian distributor for Rockford Fosgate here in Canada, automob.ca. Yes. They got some social media. Check them out, Rockford Fosgate Canada, Instagram, Facebook, all that good stuff. Get a message. If this got you excited, well, good news. They're going to have it in stock. So that's great. Steve, thank you so much for taking the time today.
Thanks a lot, Ben.
Take care.
Bye.
All right. Well, there you have it, everybody. That wraps up this CMA Connected, all about Rockford Fosgate UTV power sports stuff and the launch of that new Ranger from Polaris kit, Generation 2. We're going to continue. Keep it locked on. CMA Networks, we are deep into power sports audio. Every single day, another feature brand, one-on-one. We get to dive deep right up till Tuesday, April 19th. Continue watching the Power Sports audio sessions. Of course, I'm going to remind you to check out our website, cmanetworks.com. Hundreds of videos for you to peruse through, to learn from, whether you're searching them through category, by brand, or even by trainer. Look up Eric. Eric's got a profile on there. Hit him up. That's it. Thanks for tuning in to this CMA Connected, presented by SiriusXM. I'm your host, Ben Wu. Until next time, we connect.
Yeah,
roll it down.
I am.
You don't need a car to listen to SiriusXM. You can listen anywhere. You know that, right?
What?
Kevin Hart's left on loud radio.
Kevin, you could use your phone.
What?
What?
Alexa, play Kevin Hart's Laugh Out Loud Radio on SiriusXM.
What?
This is how I know you're getting old.
I guess that was it.
What?